I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. I'm just finishing up the install on my sister's house. It was built in 1976, radon level between 4 and 5. It's a split entry with a tuck under garage. So let's go ahead and take a look and see what's involved.
So every one of these houses that I've done so far has proven to be challenging with these tuck under garages. This one was no different. So we'll start with kind of a little bit of a tour so you can see what I'm referring to in a couple minutes. So here we've just got the bed, we've got the dresser, we've got a radon test here. We've got a radon test on the desk as well, and we'll refer to that in a minute. So coming into the laundry room here, we started with one suction point, and I want to be next to plumbing. So we end up putting a suction point under the fridge here. I spent a full Saturday and Sunday digging that suction point with a screwdriver and clay. Never found the plumbing. I dug from to about here and to about there and didn't find it. So I racked my brain trying to figure out how we could get next to that plumbing. And while I was doing that, we had a temporary radon system running. So it was pulling on this suction point and exhausting out through that window. We let it run for a week. And here's what we got for test results. We got 2.6 out on that desk. We got 1.4 on the dresser, 1.6 in the laundry room here, and 0.9 under the entryway. So I ended up getting a sewer camera, and it's got a transmitter that allows us to put the sewer camera down the plumbing, and we're able to find where that plumbing runs. So it actually ran right here under the footing, and we've got it marked here with the tape. So we ended up putting a suction point here. We found the plumbing, which had some settling. That's why we like to be next to plumbing. And I was able to tie it into my original suction point. And then we plugged that hole. We did a video on that, so you can take a look at that if you'd like to see how we do that. But as far as suction point size, I ended up with a 60-gallon suction point here, and that increased our pressure field extension, but we still weren't reaching under the stairs, or we weren't reaching very well. So we ended up adding a second suction point. We'll show you that in a second. But here's what we ended up with for results. So these are our test holes. This tubing runs back to a hole in the slab where we're measuring suction. So our goal is to create negative pressure or vacuum or suction under the entire house. And this is how we design an engineer system capable of doing that. So this is the one we're weak on, and that second suction point allowed us to reach here. So here's some of the nerdiness and the science that goes into designing and engineering a system that is gonna get your radon levels as low as possible. When we added that second suction point, you'll see that it dropped our radon levels. So here's what they were with one suction point. Here's with the second one under the stairs. Desk, we were 0.8. Dresser, 0.7. Here in the laundry room, 0.7. And in the storage room, 0.6. So let's go ahead and take a look at that second suction point. So here's our secondary suction point. We took out 15 gallons here for a total of 75 gallons of material removed below the slab. We ran this 2-inch pipe up and over, and you'll notice that we've got a valve on there that allows us to control the airflow. So we just want to sip on this. We're getting 3 CFM through here because we were able to control that valve and dial it into exactly what we need. And here's one of those test holes. So we drill a 1/2-inch hole through the concrete. This rubber stopper and tubing goes in the floor here, and it goes back to the micromanometers so we can measure the amount of negative pressure in this area of the home. So our pipe goes up. It goes over the hallway there and into the laundry room. And it ties into our primary suction point. So this is 3-inch pipe. Here's our manometer. Here's our radon system alarm. Here's our Minnesota Department of Health tag, which is all required. The second suction point, or the vent pipe for it, ties into this one just out of sight there.
but they go up through along the V vent here for the water heater. And we'll show you the route in a second, but one thing to note when you're going next to a double wall B vent, you've got to be an inch away for clearance. So you can see we kind of had to thread the needle there. When you're going through single wall, like down here, this you want to be 6 inches away from. So now we will go upstairs and take a look at the route we took. One other thing to mention, I simply could have ran up and out the rim joist and put the radon system on the side of the house. I personally would never do that if it was my own house, unless it was the only option. The reason why is I think it's really ugly to put that a radon system and pipe on the side of a house. And in the winter, you're gonna be more likely to have freeze up issues. So when you need it most, your radon system may not be working. So let's go ahead and take a look at that route upstairs. Another option I had here was to go through the closet. But Callie's son has some sensory issues, so I wanted to try to avoid that so we didn't drive the little fella crazy. So now here in the kitchen, you'll see I pulled the, this is where the fridge goes, so we pulled that away. I added this access panel so we can get access here, and here's that B vent we were looking at down in the basement. And here's my radon pipe. So this runs up from the laundry room all the way up into the attic, where the radon fan is located directly above me here. So the electrician is coming this week to wire the radon fan and add a light into the attic. So I'm hoping to get a video of that. So if you'd like to be notified when we post that, go ahead and subscribe. I'm guessing if you're watching this, you're a homeowner about to put in a radon system. What is your preferred route and why? I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thanks for watching.